गाइड करना पड़ेगा।
वेट कर लो नोटिफिकेशन दिया,
पता कैसे चल रहा है देखो तो।
अभी वो जैसे आएंगे लोग दिखेंगे कितने हो चुके हैं।
नो व्यूअर्स, I'm so sorry that it got connected, disconnected. I'm so sorry. I'm on mobile. That Wi-Fi is gone, and I'll continue with the with my mobile. If you all like, I suppose it's Pragya. Hi, Pragya. I hope it's fine. Hi, Partha. Are you there? It's good to see you again. And this, I suppose this, you're finding the story interesting. Okay. Now, Pragya, you're saying proceed. Okay, now we were at the juncture when it was Awadh was recaptured again by the British in the month of March. And of course, at the fighting was going on at Alambagh Palace. The six times the British had defeated the rebels, and Colin Campbell had recaptured Awadh, and the Begum was fleeing, and the British were trying to capture her because she was leading the rebel. So now the she was proceeding towards northern side of Awadh, where in Shahjahanpur she was joined by Maulvi Ahmadullah Shah, a very famous rebel who is quite famous in the history of Awadh, and we would be doing a story again sometime in the series. So even there they were defeated by the British, and she had to flee further north. And she went to Nanpara. From Nanpara, she went to Tulsipur, then to Devgarh. There, towards when she reached Nepal, once she was, and there was no king, no talukidar in Awadh who was ready to give her the shelter. In fact, they all saw the risk in supporting her because the British would be coming after them. If they protected her. So in fact, one of the kings, look at the way they talked to her, they said ki if I give you shelter you'll jump like a frog. This is a quote from history. This is what one Raja said to her: if we give you shelter you will jump like a frog. This is what they said, and she had to keep on fleeing towards Nepal side. And once she was surrounded by British on all the sides, and Bidris Kadr, he fell ill. He caught smallpox, and he was suffering from smallpox. But and there were offers from British side to accept that pension and surrender, but she did not accept the surrender part, and she did not accept the proposal of amnesty from British, and she kept on hiding and did not surrender. Now ultimately, the king of Nepal, he also announced the whether either the queen, the Begum, should leave the country or surrender to the British. Even Jang Bahadur, the king of Nepal, he also announced that she should surrender to the British. So it was a difficult condition for her, but still she kept on hiding in the jungles of Nepal. Finally, she could convince the king of Nepal to support her, and he she entered legally inside Nepal in 1860. The king of Nepal, Jang Bahadur, he announced that she will be giving the asylum in Nepal, and she is welcome in the country. And bungalow of a minister was Bhim Sen was given to her to reside, and she with her son, with some of his supporters, they lived a life of exile in Nepal for till she died in the year 1879. And there, in fact, she married Bidriskar Kadr to the daughter of a very famous revolutionary, Ramzan Dev. He was also a revolutionary, and his daughter's name was Ara Begum. She was married to Bidris Kadr, and it said that she even sent her daughter-in-law to Nepal to seek blessings of Wajid Ali Shah. And Wajid Ali Shah, he died around 1889 or something, and Bidris Kadr, he had 8 children, and he also died in around 1895 or something in an unknown circumstances. And that's how the royal lineage of Nawabs of Awadh ended. And this is the story, immortal story of Begum Hazrat Mahal, the way he fought for Awadh. The common man's daughter who rose more than the royalty. That's what the British. In fact, British chronicle Russell said that she was more man than a husband. She was more a man than a husband. That's what Russell said about her. So that was the story of Begum Hazrat Mahal. I hope you all liked it, and it's really tragic, and it's really heart wrenching the way she fought for Awadh, and how she met the end, which was very tragic in the jungles of Nepal. And Awadh is not going to forget Wajid Ali Shah, of course, the contribution in music, dance, and so many creative arts for the city of Awadh, for Lucknow. And of course, this Kesar Bagh Palace is no more, but we will never forget the contribution of his to the creative world of Lucknow, and of course Begum Hazrat Mahal. Thank you so much, friends, and I see so many comments, and I'm really loving it, and I'm encouraged. And let's see, we'll have another session soon. And it was so nice to have you all. So Abbas, hi, so good to see you. Jyoti, hello. And of course, I see lot many people. Bansal Saab, Partha, you're still there. You were there throughout. I hope you liked it. Wonderful having you. And Jyoti, you are there, of course. And Bansal Saab, I can see so many people again. I'm so sorry it got disconnected, the Wi-Fi connection. I lost the Wi-Fi connection, and I am on mobile. Sutapa ji, welcome. Simi ma'am, welcome. So many people. It's so happy, and we are so happy on behalf of Intact, and of course Vipul Vashni is so happy to have you. And thank you so much. Bye bye, and goodbye for now. I'll see you soon once again. Thank you.